So I had students write an autobiography in the class and then also to write out their future plan. And then I thought about that a lot. I thought, the students were really into it, you know. I mean, some of them were writing 20,000 word documents. So they were really into it. Now I set the context, you know, I taught the students that they live in a story, that people live in stories, and that you have to get your story straight because otherwise it might be a catastrophic tragedy that you're living out. And so, you know, they understood the utility and necessity of doing that. And that accounted to some degree for their concentration on the task at hand. But then I started thinking about it. So I thought, you know, I'm teaching these students. They're like 21 years old because it's an upper level course. And they've been in school for 16 years and more if they had preschool. And no one has ever sat them down and said, okay, who the hell are you and what are you doing? Justify it. Seriously.
Right.
And tell me why you're doing this. Who are you and where are you going? Write it down. And I thought, that's so weird. How the hell can that be? How the hell can we be so blind that we avoid that for 15 years? And that's even with the high-end students. And so I started doing some investigations, and I came across the work of this guy named John Gatto, who's a teacher who won the Best Teacher in New York City Award and then the Best Teacher in New York State and then quit being a teacher. And
people need to look up his work is available online. Weapons of Mass Instruction is one of his best. How he analyzes the history of school is very powerful.
Yes, exactly, exactly. And what here's the Coles Notes version. Okay, so back in the late 1800s, when the Industrial Revolution was in full swing and the rural people were moving to the cities, they were starting to work in the factories, huge working class. And while they were working in the factories, their children needed to have a place to go. Plus, their children were likely going to end up working in factories. And so they needed to be trained to do that. And so what happened was that a group of politicians, industrialists, capitalists, powerful people, turned to Prussia, which had instituted a public education system to produce obedient soldiers. And Japan did the same thing, by the way. That's why they produced all the soldiers who were like mindless automatons for World War II. And that was a conscious decision on the part of the Japanese and on the part of us here in North America. To produce obedient workers was the goal of the school system. And it was set up by fascists, essentially. And I'm not being, those weren't post-World War II fascists, right? That isn't after Hitler and Mussolini. These were people who viewed the world in terms of power and who wanted to train workers. And, you know, you can be cynical about that because they were training obedient serfs, you know. But you can also say, well, look, I mean, industrialization was occurring and so was urbanization. And it was reasonable to some degree to try to produce workers who could function in the factory settings. So that was the goal. That's why the desks are in rows. That's why the teacher is the authority. That's why they ring bells. It's a factory. Okay, so what's the problem with that? Well, maybe nothing in like 1905, but it's 2016 and those jobs are gone and people have to be increasingly autonomous and self-directed in their career decisions. And so it's time to, and there's a middle class. So, everyone virtually is in the middle class, you know, unless you've fallen out of society completely. So you need to develop your autonomous vision. And the schools were never set up to do that. And so it's like they haven't noticed that they're not doing it.
Right.